Hi everyone, welcome back to another origami lesson with yours truly. I hope that you're all having a really lovely day. It's so gorgeous outside today. Always a bit of sod's law whenever it's like that. But hey, hopefully you've got windows wherever you are, so at least you can look outside. So for today's lesson, we are going to be making the origami heron. These are just, again, really nice, easy model. If you were with us last time when we made the origami crane, you'll find that this follows a similar pattern, but it just deviates slightly when you get a little bit more towards the end, just so that you end up with a figurine that stands up like so. So I will just clear these out of the way, and I hope that you all have your paper ready to go. As always, it must be a square piece of paper, otherwise it's just not quite going to work. So let's see, what colour shall we go with today? You know, to match the sunshine outside, for the first time we will go with a yellow piece of paper. Okay. I think I'm just gonna skip this music. Okay, Google, skip. I tried to find a playlist which has actually got a little bit of a little bit more of an upbeat tune to it. So I just thought I'd best skip the last piece because Harry Potter copyrighted music, I don't think I'll really get in trouble on Instagram, but hey. Oh well, anyway. So we're gonna go with a yellow piece of paper today just to match the sunshine outside. It'll be nice and cheery. So, first thing that we need to do is create the bird base. So again, that's what we made when we started the crane. If you remember rightly, it'll be kind of like that triangle, but we'll go through it and just show you how to get there. So we start off by folding the paper in half. So you'll just fold it like this, and then you will unfold that, and then you'll fold it in half again. Lovely. Okay. So then you just fold it in half the other way. Then you unfold that, and you should see that you'll have creases that show you where four squares are. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold it corner to corner. So you'll just go like this. So you will end up with a shape like that. And then you'll do that on the other side as well. Lovely. So you'll then end up with a shape like this. So then you unfold that and you should be able to then see that you will have creases that go down the center and across the middle and go from corner to corner, just like that, okay? And then we're gonna need to make it fold in on itself to create the bird base. So I'll show you exactly how that should go. So the shape it should make should be like this, okay? And you'll see that will be the bottom of the model there, but that is how it should look. So I'll just unfold that and just show you how to get there. So we will go from here and you will end up like this. So for anyone who's joining us a little bit late, we will be going over this again from the start. We do the model twice, and we're only partway through the first one. So do hang fire or join back again in a little bit, and we'll show you how to go from the very beginning. Now, what you'll need to do next is you'll need to take these corners here and just fold them to your center crease there. So you'll fold them. Get a shape like this. Okay, so I'll just unfold that and show you what I did. So you're taking this corner and this edge here, fold that to the center there, and then fold it to the center there. And you'll see you've got like a little triangle just atop on the top there, above that line that you've got, and you'll just fold that over in half. Okay, and then you will unfold that, and then unfold those. And then what you'll be able to find is that you can then open the model up and create a triangle just like this. Okay, so I'll unfold that and show you exactly what I did there again. So you'll go from here after those creases that you've made. Oh, this has got a bit dramatic. Hold on, I'm just gonna skip this song as well. Okay, Google, Skip. I'm sorry if anyone's watching and they've got their own Google in the background, because this will be setting it off like there's no tomorrow. Anyway, so I'll just backtrack slightly. So we have gone from where we've made these folds here, like this, and unfolded everything. And then we open up the model like this. You'll find that that should flatten down into your diamond shape up there. And then we'll do the exact same thing on the other side. So again, you'll take the corners and the edges there and fold them to the center like this. So again, I'll just show you that. So you'll take this and fold it like that. And you'll do the same just on the other side there. You'll take the little triangle that pokes out on the top there and just fold that down. Okay? And you unfold that. And then you should find that if you take the bottom flap on the bottom, open that up, press that down, you will end up with your diamond shape just like this. Okay? So you'll see that all the way around, it looks like that. You should have what looks like two little legs, just on the bottom there, okay? Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take these corners again on both sides and fold them to the center using the edge. So it's just gonna make the model a little bit skinnier. Lovely, okay? So you should end up with it looking like that. So I'll just unfold that again and show you exactly what I did. So you'll take this corner and this side here, and this corner, and this side here, and you'll just fold them to meet your center crease. And that needs to be on the bottom, where you've kind of got the leg thingy going on there. And then you'll do the exact same on the other side. Sorry, I'm just laughing at what my friend Chris has just put there. I hope you got home safe and sound, Chris. I was following your journey, flying back and everything. That was so cute as well. Your mum leaving you that cooler of food in the car. That was adorable. anyway, once you've done your folds, you should end up with your model looking just like this, okay? And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold one of the legs just up like that, and then fold it on the other side as well. So it's just creating a crease for you there. So I'll just show you again. So you'll fold it up on one side like that, and then you'll unfold it, and then you'll fold that up on the other side. And then if you open your model up slightly, you will then be able to, like we did when we made the crane, just pop that on the inside there to a point. Now it might not necessarily be perfect, but because we're gonna use this to create the head of the heron, then it'll be a little bit easier anyway, just to make it look a bit more perfect. So I'll just unfold that and show you exactly what I did from this way. So you'd open it up, following the creases that you've just made, and it'll fold in like that. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this point that you've got here, like I say, doesn't necessarily matter if it's not perfect, just because it'll kind of fix itself when you make the head here. So you just fold it down one side, like this, okay? And then you'll unfold that, and then you'll just fold it on the other side as well. And then what you'll find is when you open your model up and you push that down, that will form the head of the heron rather nicely. I'm just kneading that up over here. Fabulous. Okay, yeah. So you'll see, you'll have your heron's head, just like that. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to move on to the leg, which is going to make your heron stand up. So you're just almost halfway. You will take this leg and you'll just fold it like that. Okay, so it's not folding in on itself or anything like that just yet. It's literally just a simple in half fold with the pointing out on that angle. And you do the exact same on the other side. Okay. And then what you're going to do is you're then going to fold that crease that you made basically in on itself, so it's almost like a reverse fold. So you will open it up this way. Okay. So I'll show you exactly what I did there again. Cheeky. Cheeky. Sorry, just commenting on what my friend Chris has just said there. Anyway, so I'll just show you exactly what I did again there. It'll just open up like this. Okay. And then you're kind of just going to fold that back in on itself. So it'll just come out this way. Okay. So I'll just show you again what I've just done. So we've gone from here. It's been like this. And you just kind of open that up there. Push it in. You'll see that that has just formed kind of like a stumpy little leg and a foot. And then what we're going to do is we're going to make this a little bit skinnier again, because we like to have a nice slender model. And you'll just take these edges here, you'll fold them to this point here. Okay. And we are near enough at the end of this particular design as well. Okay, lovely. So it should then end up looking like this. Okay, so I'll just unfold that and show you what I've done again. So we've gone from where your leg's been a little bit more stumpy like that. You've taken that edge, folded that to the center there on one side, and then you have done the exact same on the other side as well. So then you'll see that you've got a nice skinny bird leg just on the bottom there. Now all we need to do is just make the wings, which are these at the points at the top here. And what you'll find is you'll have almost like a little hump in the middle. If you can just see there, see that. And you should basically take this outer part of the wing and almost kind of have it follow the line of that triangle in the center, like this. You see what I mean? Take that and fold it down like that. And then you'll do the exact same with the other side. And because you've already folded one down, you can just kind of have it match up. Okay. So it would look like that. So I'll just unfold that and show you what I did again. So you go from here, and you'll end up like that. And then you do the exact same on the other side, and have that meet you there. Okay. And then you're done. Your wings are open, and you have your heron, which should stand up nice and easy. So it's a really, really easy model to make, especially if you've made that origami crane with us before. It's quite nice and simple. But just in case you missed any of the steps or there was anything you didn't quite follow, we will do it just the one more time. And I think what we will do is we will make another blue one, just because herons are traditionally blue, so why not? Okay, so we'll start again by making the bird base. So to get to that, you need to fold it in half. So take one side and get it to meet the other and try and get it as perfect as you can, just because it makes things a lot more easy if you're more precise. So you'll just do that on one side. Okay. And then you unfold it. And you do the same on the other side. Lovely. Okay. So after you've done that, you will then see that you'll have your four squares there with the creases that you've made. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lovely. Okay, and then we're going to fold corner to corner. Lovely. Okay, and then we're going to take the other corner and fold it. No, so this corner to meet this corner. Sorry. Okay. So then what you will find is once you've done all of that folding, you will have a line running down the center there and across the middle. And you'll have a line running from this corner to this corner and a line running from this corner to this corner. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to kind of have this fold in on itself. So you'll end up like that. Okay. So I'll just unfold that and show you how that should go. You should find with the creases that you've made, it should be nice and easy to end up like this. And you'll see that it looks like this on the bottom, and it looks like this all the way around. Lovely. Okay, then what we need to do is we are then going to take this corner and this edge, and this corner and this edge, and fold it to the center crease there. And you need to make sure that the open fluffy bits are on the bottom when you're doing this. Ah, this is from La La Land, one of my favorites. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you'll then fold those sides and those edges to there like that. So I'll just unfold that and show you exactly what I did again. So you'll just go this corner and this side to the center there, and this corner and this side to the center here as well. Okay, and then you'll just take this triangle from the top here, fold it over where that line is there. Okay, and just press down nice and firmly on there. Okay, and then you'll unfold all of that, and then you will take the open flap on the bottom, just here, okay, like this. You should find that your model will then open up nice and easily into a diamond shape, like that. Okay. So I'll just unfold that and show you exactly what I did there. So you'll see that you'll have all of your creases in place here after folding, so you'll see creases there and there and there. Mm-hmm. Just take the bottom, open it up like this, you get a diamond just like that. And then we do the exact same on the other side. So you'll take corners and the edges and just fold them to the center like that. Okay, so again, I'll just show you. So you take that corner and that edge and that corner and that edge and fold them to the center crease that you have there. Then you will take your triangle from the top here, and you will just fold that over as well. Okay? And then you unfold that. And then, just like on the other side, you should find, when you take the bottom flap there, that it will open out into a diamond shape. And it would look just like that. So I'll just unfold that and show you again what I just did. So you'll take this bottom flap just here, and you'll find all those creases that you've just made, that it opens up into a shape, just like that. You'll have, well, look like two little legs on the bottom there. Fabulous. Now we're gonna make the model a little bit skinnier. So we'll take this corner and this edge, and this corner and this edge on both sides, and you'll just fold them to the center. So I'll just do that, just to show you exactly what it looks like. Cool. So, you'll end up with a shape that looks like that. So I'll just unfold those again and show you. So you take this corner and this edge, and fold that to the center. Make sure you press down nice and firmly. And you do the same with this corner and this edge, and you'll fold that to the center as well. And press that down nice and firmly. And then you'll do the exact same on the other side as well. So then it will look like this all the way around. Cool. So again, you'll just have two skinny little legs on the bottom, just there, okay? And now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna pick a side, and we'll go with this side again. And you'll just fold it up like that, so it'll point out over the top of the model on one side. Okay, and press down just to create a nice solid crease there for you to work with. And then you unfold that. And then you do the exact same on the other side. Okay. You should be able to follow the crease that you'll have already made. You should be able to see that in your paper. Okay, and again, press down nice and firmly on that there. Lovely. Okay, and then you'll just open up your model and you'll push up along those creases you've just made. It should come out nicely, just like this. Okay. So I'll just unfold that and show you again what I've just done. So we've gone folding up this way, unfold, folding up this way, and then unfold. Okay, and then after you've made those, I just open up the model slightly, pull that up, and then flatten that just there. Fabulous. Now we just need to create the head of the heron. So you will take this point here and you'll just fold it down on one side like that, okay? And then you'll unfold it. And then you'll just fold down the other side, just like that, okay? And then what you'll do, similar to when you've just done to make this point here, you'll do a reverse fold, so you just open it up slightly there, okay? And then you just push the point down from the top, and you'll find that you've got your head of your heron just there. Fabulous. Now what we need to do is we need to make the leg on the bottom here. So what you'll do to make the leg is you will almost fold it in half. You'll see, if you use this as like the top, and this is just your full length of the model here, just fold it in half, put out that way, there. You see? And feel free to unfold that and do that on the other side. It'll just make doing this reverse fold a little bit easier, okay? And then what we do is we just open up the model here. And we can just easily push those creases that we've just made and make a point just there, like that. Okay? And then what we need to do is we need to do another reverse fold and just bring that in the other way. Okay? So I'll just unfold that and show you exactly what I've done one more time. So with the creases that you'll have made halfway up, you just push it and open it this way, okay? And then you do the same, bring it through to the other way. So it should look like this on the bottom, but it should look like this on the sides. And now we need to make the leg a little bit skinnier. So we're just gonna take these outside edges here and fold them to the center. So just like this, and make sure that you do press down nice and firmly, just to keep everything in place and keep it all nice and solid. Okay? So it will then look like this. You'll see that you've got a nice skinny heron leg forming. Hopefully it shouldn't be falling, it should be doing the opposite, it should be standing up when you're done. But I will just show you that again. So you take this edge here on both sides, and you just fold it to the center there, like this, okay? And do the exact same on the other side there. Lovely. Okay, and now all we need to do is create the wings. So all we do to create the wings is just fold it like this, okay? So I'll just unfold that and I'll show you exactly what you need to do again. So you'll unfold it from there. You'll just fold it like this. Okay? And then you can just make the other side meet the other wing that you have made. Okay? And you can just open those out slightly. And then with your foot on the bottom, you can open that up a little bit as well. And then you should find that you've got your heron ready and good to go. So there we have it, guys. That is how to make an origami crit. Oh, I can't seem to get my words out today. That is how to make an origami heron. I nearly said crescent. I don't know why. I don't know where that came from. Probably meant to say crane as well. Crane and heron, and it came out as crescent. Don't even know those two words are related. But yes, that's how you make your origami heron. Like I say, if you've made the crane with us before, it should be relatively simple and relatively easy for you to make. If you did struggle, please go back and watch this again. Like I say, we go through it twice each time, so hopefully if I didn't get something the first time and you missed it, you'll see it second time you watch it through. But if you did take part and you did give it a go, I would love to see how you got on making this model. So please feel free to send pictures to me via my Instagram, or if you have me on any of the social media, please send it to me that way. But I will bid you farewell, and I hope you have a lovely rest of your Tuesday. If you've not got to go out and have your designated dose of sunshine with your little bit of exercise that we're currently allowed with lockdown, please do. I'm sure it'll cheer you right up. But for now, I will see you later this week, and you have a lovely rest of your day. Take good care. Ta-ta.